Datasets and data frames equals love. Although the processing functions of the datasets library will cover most of the cases needed to train a model, there are times when you'll need to switch to a library like Pandas to access more powerful features or high-level APIs for visualization. Fortunately, the datasets library is designed to be interoperable with libraries like Pandas, as well as NumPy, PyTorch, TensorFlow, and JAX. In this video, we'll take a look at how we can quickly switch our data to Pandas data frames and back. As an example, let's suppose we're analyzing Supreme Court cases from Switzerland. As usual, we download our dataset from the hub using the load dataset function. And you can see that the first element of the training set is an ordinary Python dictionary with various fields of interest. Now suppose that before we train any models, we'd like to explore the data a bit. For example, we might be interested in knowing which legal area is the most common, or we might want to know how the languages are distributed across regions. Answering these questions with the native arrow format isn't easy, but we can quickly switch to Pandas to get our answers. The way this works is that by using the set format method, we will change the output format of the dataset from Python dictionaries to Pandas data frames. As you can see in this example, each row in the dataset is represented as a data frame, so we can slice the whole dataset to get a single data frame of the corpus. The way this works under the hood is that the dataset's library changes the magic getItem method of the dataset. The getItem method is a special method for Python containers that allows you to specify how indexing works. In this case, the getItem method of the raw dataset starts off by returning a Python dictionary, and then after applying set format, we change getItem to return data frames instead. The dataset's library also provides a toPandas method if you want to do the format conversion and slicing of the dataset in one go. And once you have a data frame, you can find the answers to all sorts of complex questions or make plots with your favorite visualization library. The only thing to remember is that once you are done with your Pandas analysis, you should reset the output format back to arrow tables. If you don't, you can run into problems if you try to tokenize your text because it is no longer represented as strings in a dictionary. By resetting the output format, we get back arrow tables and we can tokenize without problem.